validation. Validating a model means checking how well the model will perform for future prediction of unknown sample. There are three types of validation procedure: external validation, leverage correction, internal validation. If the number of sample is many, then the best validation method is external validation method. In the external validation method, what we are doing, we separate an independent set of sample, that is test set, and the calibration model is validated with the help of test set. If the number of sample is not many, so then we are using the internal validation. The third type, that is the leverage correction, it is the oldest type of validation. Nowadays, it is not commonly used. External validation or test set validation. This is also known as test set validation. And using independent sample that have not taken part in the calibration for validation. This allows one to define either a new matrix of the same number of variables as an independent check of the performance of the regression model. This is the best method for validation. The procedure of the test set validation is like split all the data into two sets, that is the test set and training set. The test set will contain 25% of the data to use an external validation independent set, while the training set will include 75% of the data to build the calibration model. In this diagram here, you see the whole data set is split into two sets, the test set which containing 25% of the data and the training set which containing the 75% of the data. This data is used to make the calibration model. Once the calibration model is ready, so then this model is validated with the help of the test set. Cross-validation or internal validation. Sometimes it is not possible to put a reasonable amount of sample aside as a test set due to the cost of sample or reference testing. So cross-validation or internal validation is preferable in their cases, in their situation. There are four different types of cross-validation: full cross-validation, segmented cross-validation, test set switch cross-validation, category variable cross-validation. In full cross-validation, leaves out only one sample at a time. Segmented cross-validation leaves out a whole group of sample at a time. Test set switch cross-validation divides the global data set into two subsets. Category variable cross-validation enables the user to validate across level of category variables. Leverage correction. Leverage correction is an approximation to cross-validation that enables prediction of residuals to be estimated without actually performing any prediction. It is based on equation that is valid for MLR, but is only an approximation for PLSR and PCR. Here you see the equation: calibration residual divided by 1 minus sample leverage. All sample with low leverage will have estimated prediction residual very close to their calibration residual. For sample with high leverage, the calibration residual will be divided by a smaller number, thus giving a much larger estimated prediction residual. When leverage correction is used to first check the model, the errors become estimation errors. The relevant validation statistics are described as follows: RMSECV, root mean square error of cross validation. This is a measure of the dispersion of the validation sample around the regression line when cross-validation is used. SECV, standard error of cross-validation. This is the RMSECV corrected for bias. Here you see what is mean by bias when there is a systematic error. Okay, so then we are doing the correction. And after correction, the RMSECV, it is known as SECV, standard error of cross-validation. RMSEP, root mean square error operation. This is a measure of dispersion of the validation samples around the regression line when test set validation is used. SEP, standard error operation. This is the RMSEP corrected for bias when leverage correction is used. To first check the model, the error becomes estimation error. How to detect nonlinearity? In other cases, there may be a nonlinear relationship between the x and y variable, so that the prediction do not have the same level of accuracy over the whole range of variation of y. In such cases, the plot may look like the one shown below. The plot will be look like this. Such nonlinearity should be corrected if possible by doing some transformation, because otherwise there will be a systematic bias in the prediction depending on the range of the sample.